Hi, I'm Victor Mathias. Here's your Channel's TV Evening News recap for March the 15th, 2020. A pipeline explosion which occurred at the Abule-Ado area around Festac town in Amuwo Odofin Local Government area of Lagos State have left many houses burnt and vehicles destroyed. The huge blast also rocked neighbouring areas, sparking a massive blaze that has destroyed nearby buildings, including a school. There are reports that scores were injured in the incident, with some speculating that several persons were killed in the blast. Official reports are still expected as regards the tragic incident. To health matters, Enugu State has reported a fresh suspected case of COVID-19, and this is confirmed in a statement from the Permanent Secretary in the State's Ministry of Health, Dr. Ifeanyi Aguji-Obi. He says the Nigeria Center for Disease Control has been informed while a sample has been collected and sent for investigations. Meanwhile, a report by the United States government suggests that the Army and the DSS intimidated voters, officials of the Independent National Electoral Commission, and even election observers during the 2019 general elections. In its 2019 country reports on human rights practices, the U.S. Department of State noted that the elections in Nigeria within the year under review were marred by violence and practices which did not encourage enough voter participation in the electoral exercise, including intimidation by security operatives. On the international scene, President Donald Trump has tested negative for the novel coronavirus, his physician said, following concerns over his exposure to a disease that has paralyzed the globe. Trump agreed to the test after coming in contact with several members of a Brazilian presidential delegation visiting his Florida resort who have since tested positive for the virus. And in sports, Nigeria's Flamingos on Saturday thrashed Guinea 5-1 in the second leg of the Under-17 FIFA Women's World Cup. The match took place at the Ayeye Stadium in Lagos State and came after the team had defeated their foes 6-1 in the first leg of the match played on the 28th of September in Conakry. And that's the evening news recap. Don't forget to join us tomorrow for the morning news update. I'm Victor Mathias. Thank you for watching.